close to you. Please stand. On behalf of the bride and groom, we'd like to welcome every one of you, family and friend. Thank you all for attending. What a beautiful day God has blessed with for this event, for the marriage of JC and Cade. Of all the relationships known among people, the most precious and perfect of all is that of husband and wife. It is therefore fitting that we should be gathered here in the sight of God to witness the vows of this man and this woman, and by our presence and our prayers, to bless their union. So let us pray together. Father God, we thank you for today, a cause for celebration in itself. Lord, we pray that on this day and every day hereafter, that you would bless and continue to bless the marriage commitment of JC and Kay. Lord God, we thank you for all of those who are here, for the safety of their travels that you made possible today, and ask for those safe travels on their return home. Today we ask that families will enjoy this time of fellowship with these two in the new family that's being created. Lord God, thank you for your son, Jesus, for what he did for us, for all the blessings that you have given to us. We ask all these things in his holy name. Amen. Ending to the end, the Bible is a love story. There, we read of God's love for his people, of his tremendous love that sent Christ to the cross, of redeeming love for the sinner, and of abiding love for the redeemed. We read also of the love of man and woman, of Jacob's love for Rachel, of Mary, who was pledged to Joseph, of the Shulamite and her beloved in the Song of Solomon. In the beginning, when the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground and placed him into the Garden of Eden, Adam was lonely. So the Lord God made a companion and helper for him. When Adam saw Eve, he was no longer lonely. God can and often does lead us to our life's companion. Abraham prayed that God would find a wife for his son Isaac, and God answered that very prayer. When Abraham's servant found Rebekah, the first thing he did was to bow and worship, praising God, and then he brought her to his master's son. The scripture says that Isaac loved her and was comforted because of his mother's death. God has guided JC and Kay to this moment, has blessed their love and brought them together to enter into the holy union of marriage. Kay, will you take this woman as your wife to live with and to hold from this day forward? Will you love her, comfort her, guide her, protect her, lead her, never forsake her, keep her honor, and keep her in sickness and in health as long as you both shall live? Will you lead her through the scriptures and lead her in the ways of God? If so, then answer, I will.
I will.
And JC, will you take this man as your husband to live with and to hold from this day forward? Will you love him, comfort him, guide him, protect him, lead him, never forsake him, keep his honor, and keep him in sickness and in health as long as you both shall live? And will you comfort him and be his partner in God's ministry? If so, then answer, I will.
I will.
Who's giving this woman to be married to this man?
I
do. We join their hands. Stacy and Cade, the ceremony of marriage in which you come to be united is the first and oldest ceremony in all of the world, celebrated in the very beginning in the presence of God. In fact, marriage is the first institution created by God. It's the foundational institution of everything else in our culture. Marriage is a gift of God, given to comfort the sorrows of life and to magnify its joys. Marriage is the clasping of hands, the blending of hearts, the union of two lives into one in the sight of God. Your marriage must stand not by the authority of the state or by the seal of your wedding certificate, but rather it stands on the strength of your love. It must stand by your devotion to one another in good and bad times. Commitment is the key. Finally, it must stand because of God's central participation in your relationship. Marriage can be the greatest human relationship you will ever experience. However, in order for marriage to reach its full potential, you must allow God to play a primary role in your relationship. He knows your thoughts and your needs. He understands your hearts and your love for one another. In fact, it was God who created the love and excitement that you two are experiencing this very moment. We can easily say God knows you better than you know yourself. If you include him, he'll help keep that delightful awareness of each other. It's often said that the ideal marriage is like an eternal triangle with each of you at the bottom of the triangle and God at the top. In that triangle, the closer you get to God, naturally, the closer you become to each other. Certainly, you want your new life to be perfect. You have visions of an eternity of joy. We talked about that in the counseling, didn't we? But let me caution you, it won't always be that way all the time. Unfortunately, sadness and heartaches find their way into every life. And however, if that eternal triangle remains unbroken, no problem is too great because all things are possible with God. Fundamentally, keep communication open between you. Always keep those lines of communication open, and life will truly be sweeter as the days go by, as the old song says. Kate, love JC as your wife with all your being, as Christ loves the church, and your wants and needs will always be met. And JC, likewise, if you will respect, love, and honor Kate as your husband, he will love you and care for you all the days of your life. Finally, let me say to both of you, remember the eternal triangle. Keep your spiritual eyes and ears open to God, the source of love, and fulfillment will be yours. Make those daily times in the Bible central and functional and essential in your lives. I promise you, He will lead you into capacities you never dreamed that you possessed. God's Word promises that in Ephesians 3:20. He can do far and exceedingly more than we can even imagine. Now, join your hands and face one another. Kate, repeat these words after me. If you believe them with all your heart, okay? I, Kate, take you, JC, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until death us do part. As God is my witness, I give you my promise. Now, JC, repeat these words after me. If you believe these words with all your heart, I, JC, take you, Cade, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8 says this. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails because God is love. God is the very definition of love. God is patient. God is kind. God's not proud. He's not self-seeking. During our marriage counseling, we discussed the idea of being perfect. The perfect partner in relationship is patient, kind, not envious, does not boast, is not proud, and so forth. There's a passage of Scripture where there's a list of what love looks like. We cannot do it on our own strength. We would fail on a regular basis. We cannot show perfect love, but God is perfect love. So if you always seek God's love, it will be expressed through you. As your love and relationship grow and blossom, I pray that you always remember what this love looks like. And I pray that each of you will demonstrate to the other what love looks like. God is love. Again, we say that. He made Adam, Eve, you, and me, and everybody here. But God has set you apart from the world. You're to love each other. Live that love continually. Love each other as you've seen demonstrated and been taught in the Scriptures. Having this kind of love in your hearts, you've chosen to exchange rings as a sign and seal of the vows that you're making today. Who has some rings? Although these rings are not huge, they're really relatively small in size. There's a very, very large significance. First of all, they're made of precious metal, and that reminds us that love is neither cheap nor common. Indeed, love sometimes costs us dearly. These rings are made in a circle. Their design, in fact, tells us that love must never come to an end. It's up to us to keep it and maintain it as continuous. As you guys wear these rings, whether together or apart for a moment, may they become constant reminders of these glad promises that you're making today. Kate, will you take your ring and place it upon JC's left hand and repeat after me this promise? Hold it there. Say, I give you this ring
I give you this ring
as a symbol of my vow.
A single with my vow.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And JC, will you take this ring and place it upon Jade, Cade's left hand? Not Jade. He's out there somewhere. Cade. JC, please repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. We're going to have a unity cord ceremony now. Scripture tells us that two people are better off than one, for they can help each other succeed. If one person falls, the other can reach out and help. But someone who falls alone is in real trouble. Likewise, two people lying close together can keep each other warm. But how can one be warm alone? A person standing alone can be attacked and defeated, but two can stand back to back and conquer. But three are even better, for a triple braided cord is not easily broken, as it tells us in Ecclesiastes 4, verses 9 through 12. Behind me, there are three strands that are to be braided together. This is to show that the bond that was made here is permanent. Guys, nothing you know will ever come between you two, not a person, not a fight, or a disagreement, or a job, or anything, especially because you have the presence of God in your life and the person of His Holy Spirit woven into the fabric of your life. Love for you, and we praise you and thank you for all that you do. God, we thank you so much for JC and Cade, for what they've done, and for the fact that they have chosen to serve you, Lord. We pray over their marriage that they will honor the commitments they've made today in the presence of these witnesses. Lord, we pray that they are like the cords in the braid. They do not become divided at any time, but will always stay together with you as the central strand of their life. Father, I pray that you will help them and us live for you every day. God, we ask these blessings today as we celebrate this joyous occasion of man and woman becoming one. And we declare our love again for you. In Christ's name, amen. JC and Cade, you've come before us and before God and have expressed your desire to be husband and wife. You've shown your love and affection by joining hands, have made promises of faith and devotion each to the other, and have sealed these promises by the giving and receiving of rings and the braiding of the threefold cord. I therefore pronounce that you are husband and wife. May God bless you and keep you and give you his peace. What God has joined together, let no man separate. Okay, please kiss your wife. So by the power vested in me through the church and the recognized by the states of Mississippi and Alabama, let me introduce to you for the very first time in public, Mr. and Mrs. Caden Lloyd.
Cause I'm faded. Money's in the streets, ain't money, you'll be made it. It could go good in my hood tonight. The summertime skirts of my guys.